And so today, Mary Berry is going to show us how to make three cheap but very nourishing dishes all in one pot. That's something you're very keen on, Mary, isn't it? Trying to get everything in one pot saves washing up and much more convenient somehow.
Yes, and also if you add the vegetables as well, it means you can don't have to set to and cook cabbage or sprouts at the end of the morning. Mm. So to begin with, I'm going to do poulet pot, Judy, and I'm using a boiling fowl. Now, they're not so plentiful, but I'm told that at the moment there's quite a glut after Christmas.
Now, I think you do normally go into a shop and say roasting chickens all over the place, but I mean, can you ask for these if they're not there? Might they get them in?
Yes, and you'll most likely see them in most supermarkets or butchers, and they're usually considerably cheaper per pound. And this, a bird will either be 18 months old, that's after one laying season, or they will be 2.5 years old. And they vary in weights from 3 to 6 pounds. The bigger bird you get, the better value you get. Mm-hmm. But it is difficult to get a big bird because the trend is to have smaller laying birds.
You were saying, actually, if you go out into the country by any chance for a run, if you get eggs at a farm, they often have these sort of birds around.
Yes, they're getting rid of birds all the time. And if you can take them with the feather on, you'll get them at half price. But you've got to get somebody to pluck them, and it's not me.
No, neither is it me.
So this one weighs about 4 pounds, and I'm going to put it into the pot or saucepan, and it wants very slow cooking. And to give flavour, I'm going to add, first of all, the neck and the gizzard, feet too. Now you'll notice that I haven't got the liver there because I'm saving the liver, and I'm going to make a little bit of patty with it, and in that way you get yet another meal.
You know, the only thing that surprises me is you're putting these ghastly things in.
Well, they're clean and they've been just run under boiling water, and it helps to give gel and flavour. We don't want to waste anything. And then onions, you quarter them if they're large. If they're small, there's no need to. And then a bouquet garni, that's parsley stalks. There's much more flavour in the stalks than in the actual parsley. Then thyme, there's still some fresh thyme in the garden.
You said you picked that in the dark, did you?
I did, yes, I nipped out. I know where it is. And I picked them with a pair of scissors. And then just tie them all together. That makes it easy for fishing it out later.
Mm. Obviously, if you have got the leaves on the parsley, there's no point in taking them off.
Well, in this particular dish, I want to sprinkle it with parsley at the end, and parsley is a bit scarce at this time of year, so if you snip off the tops, you can use that to sprinkle over. Mm. So a bouquet garni, a few pieces of carrot, and then this is chicken with a lemon sauce, so take off the peel of 2 lemons and take it off very, very thinly with a potato peeler or a patent knife like this one. Take it off very, very thinly so that you don't get any of that bitter pith.
I've never seen a knife like that, actually.
Well, it's a rather good one. It's got sort of a clip, like a nappy pin, on the top, and that helps to guide the thickness of the slice. Seems rather good.
And you can take it off, can't you?
Can.
And it's an ordinary one.
Yes, I must say, I wouldn't be bothered to take it off. I keep it as a peeling knife, and it seems very good. Also, for children, Thomas, my eldest, did the potatoes on Sunday, and I found it a very good knife, and he seemed to be able to manage it very well. Mm. There we are. I'm saving that for later to make the thickened sauce. Then cover it with water.
And they vary in sort of cooking time, do these, obviously according to weight. But
according to weight and according to age. Your 2.5 bird will take a long time, about 4 hours. Can I have the lid behind you, Judith? Mm. Yes, the 2.5 year old bird will take 4 or 5 hours to cook. This is an 18 month old bird, so it should take considerably less. And you want to either do it, bring it to the boil on the top of the stove and simmer it very, very slowly, or do it in the oven at about 325. Mm. So I'm just going to open the oven door, pop it in, and I've got one there waiting.
I must say, we look very colourful in the kitchen today. You've got some new pots, haven't you?
They are smart, aren't they?
Yeah, super.
Can you put that in the oven for me, Judy?
On the bottom, obviously.
Yes, lovely. That's it. Make sure there's room for the lid. Mm-hmm. There we are. These are non-stick ones, and you can serve them to table if you want to too. They're smart enough, and they're very easy to clean. And they don't have the intense heat that you have on the top of the stove, and therefore the non-stick really lasts for years. So take the cooked bird out of the pan and do this with a fork. Tip out all the liquid from the middle. There we are. And you can see that's beautifully tender, the way the fork's going in.
Yes, how do you check that? The same way that you check a turkey, if you prod it and make sure it comes out with a clear juice,
clear,
is that right?
Clear juice should come out, which it is. And also it should be nice and soft. not overcooking it, otherwise it'll all fall about when you carve it. Mm. And now to making the sauce that goes with the chicken, a nice strong lemon sauce. So I'm going to first of all melt 2 ounces of butter, and I would particularly use butter in this recipe. Butter seems to be very similar to the price of margarine at the moment, and it does give a really good flavour. Mm. So 2 ounces of butter and 2 ounces of flour. So I'm going to stretch over here, Julie, and I'm not weighing it because I know this is a full tablespoon, and that's 2 ounces. There we are.
I still must get one of those whiskey things. I still haven't got a simple one like that.
Well, the biggest, cheapest chain store has them. They're very, very good. And a wooden spoon, I think, for me, for making a white sauce, has gone out. I thought you just can't get the same amount of movement in the pan. Just turn the heat up in a minute. I'm being very careful to see that doesn't go brown. And then I'm going to add half stock, which I've already taken off. I skimmed off the fat. And I've got half a pint of stock and half a pint of milk.
You don't have to leave it to go cool to skim the fat off?
No, ideally you can. You can get more fat off. But I do like a little bit of richness. And one of the bonuses, too, of making having a boiling fowl is you get all that lovely, lovely juice and stock afterwards. It's really a great bonus, and you can make beautiful soups.
Which is what you're going to show us in a moment,
yes.
Aren't you?
Yeah. Now, I'm tipping this up from the heat, and so I'm stirring it until it's smooth before bringing it to the boil again.
Getting all the lumps out, obviously,
yes,
aren't
that's
you?
That's right. Yeah. If I whop this down on the very hot heat now, without giving it a good old stir, you'd find that those lumps, it would cook the flour, and it would be hard lumps, and there would be nothing you can do about it. Now, you can see, Judith, that really is becoming quite smooth already, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
The next thing you have to do is go and buy yourself a little whisk.
Oh, I must. I've been
and it's also got quite a spring in it, so it goes right into the corners of the pan. So that's all the milk included. That's half a pint. And then add about half a pint of stock until you've got the right consistency. And it wants to be, I remember at school we called it a coating consistency. Mm-hmm. In other words, so it sticks on the outside of the chicken. And you've got the lovely goodness of the chicken in the stock. And by the way, season the stock well. I didn't put any, I don't think, in it. You should add about a heaped teaspoonful of salt and black pepper before you start stewing the bird. And then it'll get a really good flavour.
Mm. That's coming up very well now.
Isn't it? Mm. Let's give it a good old beat.
You're putting lemon in this.
I am indeed.
Why?
I mean, because this is a lemon flavoured dish, and
it's a pretty obvious answer.
Well,
isn't it?
It is. I mean, you could if you wanted to add all sorts of things like tomato or whatever you like. Now, I'm not going to use quite all this stock.
Obviously, the lemon's got a sharpness in it, hasn't it?
It's got a sharpness, and it really is delicious. I think perhaps I like lemon. I put it in a lot of things. And you've also, as we've put the lemon rind in the dish, this means that you've already got a lemon start. There we are. And then I'm just going to let that absolutely boil now. It's just coming. You can see steaming. And you must add the lemon juice just at the very, very last minute. If you add it before you add the milk, you'll find that it will curdle in the pan. Mm.
But it can be at the absolute boiling point when you add it.
Oh, yes.
It's not
it won't
affect
curdle.
It that way.
Once the flour has thickened your sauce, you're all right. There we are. There, it's really boiling now. In with the juice of 2 lemons. And that's a thing you can do ahead. So if you're wanting to do this just before the meal, it doesn't take very long. I think I've taken about 5 minutes to make this sauce. Mm. Mm. Here we are.
And then one thing I tried at Christmas after that was put that piece of greaseproof, if you did do it before, that's just right. To keep it from getting a skin on. I'm learning, you know.
Oh, jolly good. So there we are. That's a lovely consistency. And a good consistency, that means that it's got a nice shine on it. And that has a beautifully smooth. And if you want to put part of it on, and then you can put the rest in a sauce boat. And that's just a coating consistency. Mm. Just going to put this over here. And then that does look rather anemic, and so put some freshly chopped parsley. And this could be the remainder from your parsley stalks. Mm.
Totally nice.
And if you've got all this beautiful stock left, you could make that into soup. And as a thickening agent, you could use split peas, that's the green ones, and or you could use lentils as a thickening agent. And lentils and split peas are particularly good to have in the larder because they do last 2 years without deteriorating.
I think that's something I'm rather lazy about, having those sort of things and making soups with things, and really one should do, because there's a lot of good in them, isn't there?
Yes, and also it has the advantage you don't have to watch it or do anything. You just put them in and gently simmer, and then they act as a thickening agent. And you could also liquidise the vegetables and put in the soup too, because we've still got in here there's some lovely carrots and onions, and those could be liquidised in soup. So there we are, the chicken. Very Let's good. Get on with the
In that
recipe.
Amount of stock, you just put those sort of amount of split peas and things in?
No, just about either 2 ounces of lentils or 2 ounces of split peas.